People often ask, what's the difference between application and implementation data types in AUTOSAR? Hello, I'm Yatish, Chitluri from Oldenburg in Germany. I'm glad to meet my colleague Nabile Khoury here at beautiful Taj Mahal in India to talk about this topic.
Hi Yatish, yeah, this is a very nice place. I'm really glad to be here. So let's get started with the role of data types in AUTOSAR architecture.
Yeah, so a data type in AUTOSAR has primary role to describe and implement the data exchange between software components. It defines, among others, data attributes such as numerical range of values, physical semantics, and when needed, the structure of the composite data such as an array or a structure.
Right, and for the implementation, we need additional information such as the bit size, the fixed point or floating point representation, the memory arrangement, the bit alignment, etc. And the question is, should all this be defined with one data type concept?
Well, before AUTOSAR 4.0, there was a single concept of primitive data type. It tried to define everything, including what the data is and how to implement the data in the code. This required a lot of anticipation while working on the higher architecture level and had some downsides. The system engineer had to prevent naming conflicts between the data types, and when needed, an implementation change in the code, the higher architecture must be updated.
Yes, right. So depending on the architecture level, not all details are needed. So since AUTOSAR 4.0, the standard separates the data type definition in three abstraction levels. So from top to bottom, we have number one, the application data type. It really focuses on the application perspective to define what the data is. This includes things like physical semantics, range of values, data structure.
Yeah, and we have the implementation data type. It basically defines how to convert the data description into a type def in the code. It leaves the choice for things like bit size, integer, or float representation, memory arrangement, pointer usage, etc., depending upon the actual implementation constraints. Therefore, it releases the system engineer from too much of anticipation. And then, at the bottom, we have the base type. This is the closest abstraction to the platform, which can specify the bits definition down to things like NDNS and alignment. So, Nabil, which one to use though?
Well, first of all, the runtime environment can only use implementation data types. Therefore, on the technical level, implementation data types only could be sufficient. Some AUTOSAR elements are even limited to the use of implementation data types, such as basic software modules, libraries, or AUTOSAR services. However, on the application level, the application data type extends and uniformizes how to define the data. It can also support additional attributes like curve, accesses, and in addition to that, it helps measurement and calibration tools to have a better access to the data.
Yes, and for flexibility and completeness, I think it makes sense to define the data types according to these three layers. AUTOSAR offers a mapping mechanism to connect an application data type to an implementation data type and even allows to map many application data types to one single implementation data types.
Yes, thank you, Yatish, and thank you for watching. If you find this video useful, please give it a like and follow us on LinkedIn or YouTube for more videos.